It's getting there. I'm trying to give it a few days off.
Francis woke me up twice last night because I swore because I can't breathe.
Yeah.
I'm just going to crash. I'm woken up anymore.
It works better. It's better. How's your shoulder doing?
Better. Yeah. Went to the chiropractor yesterday. He did a lot of ART on it. He actually thinks it's like mostly pec and less bicep tendon. Try and actually take holidays off when they come up, but I'm like, just pay. I just end up paying for it. So like, what's the point? It's not relaxing. Right? One day of relaxation, then 4 days of hell.
It's a tough compromise.
Single leg X, and this week we'll be going into infinity armor. That's my way to do it. Although it's nice to see you, like I know. We'll either look at Della Diva or we'll look at X Guard, depending on what I'm seeing in the room. But the big thing is we'll start out with that inversion drill since everybody seems to struggle with that a little bit last year. So what we're going to do is just observe for now. Grab a spot on the wall. And to get started, you just kind of want to rock back and touch your feet to the wall a few times.
This is going to let you know how far you are
from the wall.
I want to be able to touch my toes to the wall without
moving my knees. The reason being is that when we're playing any kind of open guard, I'm essentially maintaining this organized position the entire time, because as soon as I start to separate, whether it's my knees moving away from my torso or my arms moving away from my torso, the pass box starts to open, like sands pepper. When I say pass box, I mean this area between my shoulder and my hip. From here, I'm nice and secure. As soon as I start to open, I'm not secure. Sands can start controlling this space. So, regardless of what I'm doing, whether it's closed guard, whether it's open guard, supine guard, I'm constantly thinking about keeping the pass box closed. And that's why when we're here on the ball, we're thinking about keeping everything nice and organized. I want to be just far enough
so my toes touch and I can still maintain this organized structure with my knees and my elbows. So we're going to tap a few times. And then we're going to start to invert. To invert, I kind of do this foot crossing motion and post.
To go in this direction, I'm taking my left hand, I'm feeding it under.
That gets me up on my shoulders and puts me right back where I started.
To go in the opposite direction, I cross my feet, my right hand goes under.
The entire time I'm staying connected with the wall, it's like I'm walking down the wall. The entire time I'm staying in this organized structure position, and I'm just walking down the wall. This requires very little effort.
So grab a spot on the wall. The room is really spinning out. And just practice that at your own pace. Thank you.
No.
Yeah, there's too many of us to do that.
It's that spin back around, man, right?
It's harder than that.
Everybody's doing a pretty good job of getting to here, but I'm seeing some crazy shit. Trying to go in the other direction. It seems weird. It's not the legs that I'm driving this movement. It's really just this arm reaching under. It's like I'm trying to skin my knuckles against the wall. And that's going to get me up on this line that goes across the back of my shoulders.
Timber.
You know, now you're doing it right because it's almost effortless. I'm reaching deep. It's like I'm trying to skin my knuckles against the wall here. And you'll notice too that when I'm following through, my fingers are actually touching the wall. And that's going to help me turn. Keep trying. 3, 2, 1. Continuing with the warm-up we've been doing for the past couple of weeks, we've been looking at maintaining this supine guard position, just to echo what I've said in previous weeks. This is not a place we want to fight from for an extended period of time. This is essentially like a bailout move. We're playing this guard to retain our guard and then get back to a more offensive guard. So if I'm playing this guard against Dick, he's trying to pass my guard, go ahead, just do whatever you want.
You know, I'm staying here, keep going. Maybe like a little bit of that. I'm staying here until I can get something else. I'm not gonna fight for 5 minutes in this position.
But we do need to learn how to use this position effectively, because we are going to be in situations where We need to buy ourselves some time to set up our guard and set up our offense. So that's what Mr. Grail is going to help us with. So with your partner, if you've been here the past couple of weeks, this is not new to you, but if you haven't been, just to recap. Over here, Nick's going to come and make contact without hitting my elbow. He's going to beat me slightly. He's going to compromise this line that's coming out of my hip joint. I'm going to pummel to his near side arm and adjust. He's going to go again. He beats me a little bit more. I go to his far side arm and adjust. He really beats me. Now I invert. This is where that drill we just did is going to help you. I'm reaching through, and instead of dragging my knuckles across the wall, I'm looking for your shin bone and rotating through. Now we're going the opposite direction. He beats me a little bit. Near side pummel, re-guard. He beats me a lot. Far side pummel, re-guard. He beats me even more. I invert. I slap his leg with the back of my palm. And I come back to my guard. I've never believed in this position. So pick a partner, somebody close to your size. Just practice that at your own pace. 3, 2, 1. Giving my partner the frames he needs to re-guard the pump. Like, if I'm up here, he's never going to be able to reach my upper body. He might be able to reach my hips. But the person on top, I really want you to think about getting the low for this style of passing. 3, 2, 1. That pass box flows through the inversion. So we're going to continue ramping this up a little bit. It'll be a 2-minute drill. Person on top is giving like at most 50% resistance. Person on bottom, all you're trying to do is just retain the guard. You're not trying to submit, you're not trying to sweep, you're just trying to maintain this recumbent guard position. By the time you're done, your core should just be totally geared up. Your back might be a little slashed up tomorrow too from all this pivoting, but Nick's gonna give me all kinds of feeds, and I'm just gonna try and hang on here for as long as I can. This is a very active drill. It's gonna look crazy and you're gonna be tired.
You group at three, just switch however you want to switch. You're 30 seconds, whatever. It'll be a 2 minute drill. Because
one side going the entire time?
Yeah, one side going the entire time. That's switched off and on.
First on top, 60% resistance and ropes. Remember, first on top, give them that air crawl feed. You shouldn't be standing straight up and down. That's another style of passing when we're just not covered together. Position, it's very easy for Nick to just do a quick throw line and get by my guard. I have no pummeling option to stop the guard fast. And if you have both legs up, I'm just asking to be stacked here. So I'm constantly one up and one down, and I'm switching them. Something to think about as you're on the bottom. Let's keep going. Yep, you just finished out the round. I just forgot to mention that. I saw a lot of people making that mistake. Same thing goes for my arms. If I'm playing an open seated guard, I want contact with him to start to sweep or submit. As soon as I start to do this and reach, the pass box starts to open. Just be mindful of that. It's a common pitfall that I see taller people, long-limbed people fall into. It's something I wish I figured out sooner rather than later. I was still struggling with this. So keep that in mind. So we're talking about it.
Thank you.
occasionally you're putting your foot on the floor, is it? It's okay if it's not great. If your foot's on the floor, you're limiting your mobility. It's also opening the half
spots.
So, too.
It's
just like, if I'm looking to pass somebody who has a really stubborn overcoming guard, I'm psyched if I can get one of their feet stuck to the floor. It's going to make it easier. So any observations from that 4 minutes in hell?
Tomorrow.
Other than the quality of your performance.
You want to try to trap them between your legs.
Yeah.
Keep them in your crosshairs. You can set up frames.
That's a good one. Anything else?
Separating the legs really helped me. Before you said that, I realized I was doing a lot of the same.
Yeah.
And he was passing it a lot easier. Also, just it gives you different spots to try to go for.
Even more fundamental than that's all about. Even more fundamental than that.
And I have to be more flexible than
that. All right. My super baseline observation is that you're all fucking tired.
Yes.
That's exhausting, right? Like, you don't want to spend a 5 minute match doing that. You could use that, and this is just my opinion. You know, other people might disagree. But I'm saying this to somebody who's 36 years old and kind of a hobbyist in this sport. If I'm going to go do like a weekend competition, I don't want to be doing that for 5 minutes. I might use it strategically to wear somebody out, like if I get a sense like, okay, I'm in better shape than this guy, or maybe they have a passing style that's really aggressive. I think my opening guard is dead, so I'm going to force them to do this over and over and over again until they get tired. I just want you to kind of be mindful of like when and how you use that. And the way I like to use it is to get into a more offensive guard. So if I'm playing this against Nick, last week we'll review, who was not here last week? You know single leg X. Andre, you know single, okay. Sam, you know it. You know single leg X, right? Alright, so we'll review single leg X. I'm using this to get to one of my favorite guards. And usually, you know, it's either going to be like, Nick starts to commit. As soon as I feel like I have some contact with this leg, whether it's with this arm or this arm, I know I can get to a guard that I want to get to. And that's either going to be single leg X, or it's going to be, or I'm sorry, that's either going to be Dela Ipa, or it's going to be single leg X, or preferably my beloved X. But usually the entry point is either single leg X or Dela Ipa. Last week we looked at single leg X, we'll look at single leg X again, just because we have some brand new folks here, and you know, no offense, but nobody was like exactly killing it last week either, so we can use a little bit more practice myself. So we're in this recumbent guard position, and our opponent is giving us a dynamic read. Like, they're not just standing there. What I'm looking for to initiate my sequence for establishing my single leg X or my Dela Ipa is this grip. As soon as I have contact with this grip, or it could be this grip, if I want to, this is just my left is my better side, but I need a heel grip. I'm looking to capture this heel bone. I'm not up here. I'm low. I'm right on the heel bone. The reason I'm low is because the lower I am, the easier it's going to be for me to sweep, the easier it's going to be for me to launch leg attacks. I'm thinking about my pinky being against the mat. But as soon as I have this connection, I know I can start to enter my guard. From here, This left leg is swimming through and up onto the hip. My right leg, this is something I've been playing with, guys. You might actually want to come around on this side. Kind of where me and Eddie are. So one of the pioneers of the single leg X-Bar was Marcelo Garcia. He's the head of our association. And the way he kind of pioneered it was the inside leg is on the back of the hamstring or like in the butt. And you'll notice my hips are up here. Like all my weight is going into the mid. Not playing flat on my back. This is not an art. This is a band. But the traditional approach was to have this leg kind of cupping the back of his hamstring. Gordon Ryan has changed jiu-jitsu in many ways. Some ways for good, some ways for bad. But I really like his approach to seeing the leg X, and I've been playing with this the past couple weeks. So my knee, instead of being kind of out here in space, connects to my ankle bone. And you notice like just that movement alone caused that little hop in it. And the reason why I think this is more effective is now I've taken this leg out of play too. Like here, he can hop around on that back leg. Here he can. So when I go sweep, it also gives me an option to keep this leg out of the way so I can start to attack my own device. So when you're setting up with your single leg X, you can play with either of those two feels, whichever speaks to you, neither of those wrong. But I really think there are advantages to this word and right approach. So what you're gonna do with your partner is gonna give you a very slow but dynamic feel. I get my heel capture nice and low. My left leg goes through, and I'm planting my instep on his hip bone. This is almost like a step for me. My right leg splits him, and either I'm going for the classic single leg X, where my instep kind of cups the back of his butt, or my knee is pinned to my heel bone, and my instep cups the back of his heel. I just want you to get to here for now. Time here, gives me some sort of dynamic feel. I capture the heel, my left leg swims through, targets his hip bone, my right leg goes between his legs and either cups the back of his hamstring or my knee goes to my ankle bone and cups on the back of the opposite hamstring. My hips are up. My hips are low. Any questions? Yeah, so in the gi, I can't beat him. So he has this line going down his midline. My heel cannot cross that line. And the reason being is it puts the knee in danger. In no gi, this is okay. And the thinking here is as soon as I should cross the midline, it exposes his heel low and I can start to attack with it. But that is not the goal of me. Right. And like, if you were to do a competition as a white belt, it might be illegal for you to pound on and stuff. Because you feel like it's dangerous. It's really more dangerous than any other position. But problem is that if you tear your ACL, as you know, as a trainer, it's a much bigger deal than if you have damage. It's like you're at 6 months of being surgery. So. Any questions?
First, cupping the heel, how do you keep it from stepping out of it? Do you rip it at all, or is it just a speed thing? You just grab it?
So, I'm just connected to him. I'm not really gripping super hard, but if he tries to step, he's actually pulling me into position.
Okay.
Like, I'm not holding on to your life here, but I'm just maintaining the connection, if that makes sense.
Yeah, are you throwing your hips under me? Normally, your hips are not that.
Yeah, I'm using this as a grip to kind of pull myself in and under, so. From here, as soon as he makes that connection.
Yep.
Any other shot? 3, 2, 1.
Thank you.
it's not right. Right.
Yeah.
You can try it. I mean, yeah, yes, it's hard. You know, had that, like, it's
yeah.
Lots of it.
Who's like, still, he's not to me.
Oh, okay. Yeah. He's got all he's doing is he's gonna have to mess with
you. That's the definition of that.
There. Everybody's doing a nice job starting from here and establishing your connection. Everybody's doing a decent job chopping this leg through. When I'm going to transition my single leg axe, I'm thinking about connecting my leg to his leg and I'm never used. It's always in contact. But this circle that I'm making is tight. And that's going to make it, okay, that's going to establish more control. Right, like if I do this big arching loop out here, that gives him a good opportunity to grab my leg and start to stack. This is another uncomfortable shift today, so I'm thinking about keeping this nice and tight. It's like my knee is just rotating around his knee. You really want to stick the landing here. I'm targeting his hip bone, and this is like a step. As I'm throwing my legs up, I'm standing on it. I'm like, just watch how his balance changes. Whereas if I'm here, he's steady. It might expose his heel if I give me a better attack option, but right now we're looking at this as more of a sweeping position. So really want you to emphasize standing on that hip. The other thing I want to emphasize is that when I lock this up, this is tight. It's like I'm squeezing his leg. Like, watch what happens just from me tightening this up. His balance starts to get disrupted. If I'm loose here, that doesn't happen. He gets unsteady. So it's a combination of stepping into this hip and bringing my weight up, and also pinching if I want. This is a lot. I want to move this into the sweep, and then we're going to move on. So here, I've established either the Gordon Ryan option or the Marcelo Garcia option. And to initiate the sweep now, all my weight is up and driving into him. I'm going to pull him this way and then bring him in the opposite direction. A lot of people make the mistake of just trying to push him this way. And it might work, but you know, when he makes a purple belt, he knows exactly where I'm going to be sweeping. It's this way.
So I really need to scramble his brain a little bit in order to make the sleep work. So I'm here, and I'm wrenching it forward, and then I'm coming backwards quickly and coming up to the sleep. So practice that a few times with your partner. Does anybody have any questions about that first?
Is there anything you can do with wrenching him forward, or is just the
problem? Oh yeah, sure. So it's kind of unlikely that this will happen, but let's say, you know, I give him a hard bump and his hands go to the mat. This is when I'm going to come to the next guard to do a get up sweep, or if I come to the back. So there's plenty of things I can do, but most of the time I find that forward pressure is not going to be enough for me. It's totally playing it out. 3, 2, 1.
Do you want to start a guard or do the whole entry?
Do the whole entry, practice the whole thing. So you're going entry to guard to sweep.
So remember, for the person who's playing guard, you got to get those hips up. You got to drive your weight up and through your partner. So we're going to finish out the class with positional training. We're going to scale this as we go through. First round, these are all going to be 5-minute rounds. One partner's going to be down, the other's going to be up. All the person on the bottom is trying to do is get to a guard. If you don't know any guard from this position, you at least know single leg X now. But any guard is fair game. If somehow you can get your partner in closed guard, that counts. Half guard, that counts. Belliva, that counts. You establish a guard, you hold it for 3 seconds, and you reset. Person on the bottom is going to stay on the bottom for half a round. Halfway through the round, I'll switch you. We'll switch top and bottom. And we're going to progressively move and open up options as we go through the class.
Just guard.
All we're in the first round is guard. I'll work with
you. So you pass the sweep in a second.
Now you're trying to pass the sweep. You're just trying to get to a guard.
Okay.
So,
Let me demonstrate.
The guy on top of B.
Exactly. Nick's trying to pass my guard. I get two X guard. One 1,000, two 1,000, three 1,000. I start over. We're just trying to get to A guard. Push out bottom. That's it. First on the bottom, starting the same exact way. Right here. One, two, three. That's it. Questions?
How much resistance comes up?
This is normal rep.
Normal rep.
Three, two, one. Same deal, switch it halfway.
We'll switch it.
Two part.
Switch after sweep, 250 moving.
Yeah, here's a sweep, start over. And we're gonna, I'll split the round, same person down for two and a half.
Monkey brain.
Thank you.
starting with the single leg axe on. You can either use Gordon Ryan or Marcelo Garcia, but we're starting from here. If there's a sweep, or if the person on top passes, reset. You don't have to stay in single leg X guard the whole time. You can move to other guards. So my objective on the bottom is to sweep. Person on top's objective is to pass. Questions? You're able to. Come on. Sorry. Here we go.
We're not switching. I'm going to switch.
I'm going to switch you halfway through. New partner.
Joe, why don't you go first and whoever?
Did you just go?
I'm on her one thing.
Let's go.
Just kick Danny in the face.
Yeah, it's fucking deep.
Sorry, you could do it being a little less handsome.
So you could do it being a little less handsome.
Thank you.
my initial feels so weird.
Yeah. I don't feel any, so a couple things are missing here. There's no pitch, and I don't feel any upward pressure. That's what's going to start disrupting your balance. Yeah.
I'll just stop hitting this card for this.
I mean, look at that. Like Marcelo Garcia is a tiny guy.
He's quiet there.
Yep. Yep.
I
got
to run to breakfast. Yep.
All right, last round. Pearson's dipping out. It's going to be a short round. It's just full round. One person starting from the recumbent guard, the other person starts standing. If there are points or a submission, switch top and bottom. So how does this issue happen if you run your switching yourselves? Points or submissions, switch top and bottom.
Two cards.
Two, sir. I'm going to do it.
Big pitch,
Joe.
Well, we got an even number now. So
okay.
Anyway.
Did you go to
the other day?